Hello, students. Today we are going to discuss about a particular kingdom which is unique with its characters, and that is Kingdom Fungi. Clear? So we are, this fungi is somehow known to us. We have seen it in the orange peel, the greenish layer forming in the orange peel, on the bread. We have seen mushroom. We also, we are often in the, in this monsoon, in the woods we find that bracket like structures, those are the fungi. So we are to some extent familiar with the fungi, but today we will discuss the details about those. This is a separate kingdom we know, and we will discuss about it. Now, fungi, we know they are the decomposer. They are they keeps our environment clean. Now, so where will they live? They do not have chlorophyll, so they are heterotrophic. So they have to take food somewhere, clear, and that is why they can live on the living organism as in parasitic mode, or they can live in the dead decayed matter like dead woods, clear, decayed organism, decayed plant matter. So these are the region, even the soil there, from they take the food from the decayed matter. So all these are the common habitat of fungi. Now, what about the body? If you go on for the fungal body, you will find that after the spore, it generally, fungi, generally they reproduce by spore and germinates. When the spore germinates, it gives rise to fine tubular structure which are called hyphae. So when the spore germinates, fine tubular structure which are multicellular. So multicellular tubular structure appears, clear, and these are called hyphae. Now these hyphae generally are intermeshed. You can see numerous hyphae are intermeshed to form the mass called mycelium. So when it is simple thread like structure, single thread like structure, we call it hyphae, clear, and singular hypha. And when these threads are intertwined or interwoven to form a mass, then we call it mycelium. So fungal body is like the this tubular thread called hyphae, which are often interwoven to form a mass called mycelium. So first of all, spores germinate to form hyphae. This branching of hyphae, hyphae underwent branches and it gets interwoven and finally form the mesh called mycelium. Now, why they are forming this mycelium? Clear? Because they are heterotrophic, so they have to take food from others, whether it is dead or living. So how they will take food? Either they will directly absorb the food from the other body, or they will extracellularly digest the food and absorb it. So somehow they have to absorb the food. Now, more the surface area, if they can increase the surface area, they can absorb more food, clear. So they does not lose in height, clear. This grows throughout the surface, clear, because to provide more surface area for the absorption of food. Now, one exception is this yeast, though, that is Saccharomyces cerevisiae, Saccharomyces, clear, they are unicellular, and often these unicellular structures, by budding, they form a chain of cells, clear. So this yeast is unicellular, by budding it forms a chain of cells, and this chain of cells appears that like that of the mycelium. So it is not the mycelium. It appears that of the mycelium. So it is called pseudomycelium. Clear? It is called pseudomycelium. But now there are again a deep thing, controversy there, whether yeast is within fungi or not, because we know that all unicellular eukaryotes are under protista. Clear? Kingdom protista. Unicellular eukaryotes are under kingdom protista. So whether Saccharomyces is under fungi or in protista, that is also a question. Now, next is the cell structure. So next is the cell structure. If we go on for the cell structure, we'll find it is without chloroplastid. The cell wall. The cell wall is made up of a carbohydrate, polysaccharide, which is called chitin. Clear? The cell wall made up of chitin. And chitin is a homopolymer of N-acetylglucosamine. So cell wall is made up of chitin, which is a homopolymer of N-acetylglucosamine. Clear? It is chemically, it is more or less similar to that of the chitin present in the insect, but in insects it is hard due to impregnations of other substances on that polysaccharide. But here it is soft. Clear? Here it is not so hard, it is soft as because there is no impregnation of any other substances. Clear? So it is the homopolymer of N-acetylglucosamine, which gives a soft leathery texture. Now, next is the chloroplast is absent, we know. All these other organelles are present, like endoplasmic reticulum. Golgi bodies, rather we call dictyosome, having are unicisternae, that means having one cistern. We can see glycogen, oil droplets, vacuoles, all these are present, like that of the other cells. And another thing is that the nucleus. Nucleus is comparatively smaller than the plant nucleus. And very interesting and unique feature is that when the fungal cell undergoes cell division, the nuclear envelope does not disappear. Spindle is formed within this nuclear envelope, and this is called karyochoresis. So when this fungal cell undergoes cell division, we know that normally during cell division, they disappear. But here, during fungal cell division, the nuclear envelope does not disappear. Spindle is formed within the envelope, and this is called karyochoresis. Another thing is the hyphae. You can see here, hyphae, this is also hyphae. This is the nucleus. And there is no wall in between. So it is a multinucleate condition. Clear? It is a multinucleate condition. This is called synocytic hyphae or multinucleate hyphae, which is found in the lower groups of fungi. Clear? So there is no cross walls in between. And so a hyphae, the tubular structure contains numerous nuclei. Clear? And these multinucleate hyphae are called synocytic hyphae, which is mainly present in the lower groups of fungi. In higher groups of fungi, we find that there are the nuclei separated by the cross wall, which are called septa. Clear? These cross walls are called septa. And so this type of hyphae are called septate hyphae. And this septa is also may be complete septation. That means it may emerge from one end and it will ultimately continue to the next end. Clear? So that is called continuous septa. But in certain, especially in the basidiomycetes, we find the discontinuous septa. That means in between there are certain gaps. Clear? So you can see here, there is discontinuous septa. That means there are certain gaps in between through which the materials can move from one cell to other easily. So these are the septate hyphae. Clear? And this is multinucleate synocytic hyphae, and these are the septate hyphae, uninucleate. But interestingly, fungi also contains dinucleated hyphae. Clear? Now, often in certain stage of their life cycle, we'll find they contains two nuclei in each cell. So that is called dikaryon phase. Clear? So that is called dikaryon phase. So they have multinucleate hyphae, calcinocytic hyphae in lower groups of fungi. They may have uninucleate hyphae with complete septation, or they may have uninucleate hyphae with incomplete septation, and even may they have, they may have binucleate. Clear? Each cell contains two nucleus. This is called at certain stage of their life cycle, and that is called dikaryon or dikaryotic phase. Now, another thing is the nutrition. So, what about the nutrition of fungi? Already we have learned that fungi are heterotrophic. So, their nutrition varies from parasitic to saprophytic to symbiotic. Clear? When they are parasitic, they enters on the surface. So suppose this is the body, clear, on which they are parasite. The part of the hyphae enters there, they form the massive structure which are called hosteria, clear, which are there to absorb the food materials from the living body. Clear? So when they are parasitic, they enter, the hyphae enters into the hosts, they produces hosteria and absorb the food from them. Now, they may be saprophytic. When they are saprophytic, they have extracellular digestion. That means they release the digestive enzyme outside in the organic matter, dead and organic matter. They digest those materials, and after digestion is complete, they absorb this digested food. So here the digestion occurs outside the cell, and that is called extracellular digestion. So saprophytic fungi often have extracellular digestion. And another one is the symbiotic hyphae, symbiotic fungi, clear, where they have mutual understanding with other organisms. Generally, they are green organisms who can prepare their food. And these fungi, which cannot prepare their food, but due to their surface area, this extensive surface area, they can absorb water, minerals from the soil or from the substratum and provide to its partner. Clear? So here, when they are in symbiotic association with algae, we call it lichen. Algae is green, so it provides the food, it synthesizes food. And fungi, being non-green with large surface area, absorbs water, minerals and provide it to algae for the synthesis of food. Clear? And so it is called lichen. Now another one is there called mycorrhiza. Mycorrhiza is also an association of fungi with the roots of higher plants. The same thing happens here also. The roots of higher plants, from the roots of higher plants, they take the nutrition and they helps in absorption of water, minerals, clear, to those roots which cannot enter or which cannot move that fine areas, fine cracks, clear. So there they increases the surface area, they moves into the fine cracks and they absorbs the water and minerals for the roots, and roots in turn give the food to the fungi. And this type of association is called mycorrhiza, mycorrhiza. So mycorrhizal association, fungi with roots of higher plants. And what is the reserve food? Very interestingly, their reserve food is glycogen, like that of the animal. We know that plant, the reserve food is starch, but in fungi, the reserve food is glycogen, like that of the animal. Reproduction is vegetative reproduction by fragmentation. Any parts may divide, fragmented. In budding, we have seen budding in yeast, clear. So that also a mode of vegetative reproduction. The certain fission is also there. Sometimes some compact structures like sclerotia or rhizomorphs are formed, which perinates. the unfavorable condition and again grows during favorable condition. But mostly they reproduce by asexual mode of reproduction. Fungi spreads very quickly, and they very quickly they spreads by the structure called spores. These spores are highly thick walled structures which can perinate in unfavorable condition easily and can spread through various parts, and finally in favorable condition they germinates. Clear? So various types of spores are found in fungi. The spores which are produced by mitosis are called mitospores, and certain spores are formed which are formed after the sexual reproduction by meiosis, that is called meiospores. Now here are certain spores like zoospores. Clear? You can see here the spores are, these zoospores are flagellated. Zoospores are flagellated. They are coming out of the zoosporangium. Clear? So phytophthora, all these have the zoospores, which are flagellated spores coming out of the zoosporangium, which will be liberated, and ultimately when they get favorable condition they will germinate. Another one you can see here, these are the sporangiospores. Clear? So these are the mycelia. Now when the sporangio, they are supposed to form the sporangiospores, some of the mycelia, because mycelia generally grows horizontally to the ground, some of these mycelia grows vertically upward. The several nuclei gets accumulated in this region. This region gets swelled and form the sporangium. Clear? And these nucleus now get encircled with cytoplasm, cell membrane, and now form various spores. And after it is totally matured, this sporangium bursts and the spores are liberated, which then germinate in favorable condition. So they are non-motile spores which grows in the sporangium. So they are called sporangiospores internally within the sporangium. Now there is another form of spores. This is called conidia. Conidia are the, this sporangium we have learned, this is internal, and these conidia are the external spores. Clear? These are the, this is the vertical horizontal mycelium. When the vertical mycelium give rise to externally to the non-motile cells which acts as a spores, and these are called, this track, this vertical hypha is called conidiophore, and it provides a, cuts the non-motile cells which are called conidia. Clear? So this, how will you differentiate? This is endogenous, this is exogenous. Clear? And both are non-motile. Now another type of spore is ascospores, which are the meiospores. That means after sexual reproduction by meiosis these spores are formed. Clear? These are formed within the sac called ascus, and these are the spores which are non-motile. These are called ascospores. Another spore is the basidiospores. Clear? These are basidiospores which are exogenously produced on the club-shaped structure called basidium. Exogenously produced on the club-shaped structure. So you can see. So basidium bears the basidia and ascus bears the ascospores. Both are the meiospores. That means both are produced after the sexual reproduction, meiosis occurs, and thus they produce their spores. Now it is endogenous, it is exogenous. It is born on the ascus, it is born on the basidium. Clear? And these are all haploid spores obviously. And now what is the wise fungi? Fungi are the decomposers. Clear? They, and we know that fungi are highly, their distribution, they extensively distributed. Clear? And what, one of the reason for this extensive distribution of fungi is the spores. Most of them, roughly all of them, reproduce by spores, whether it is asexual spores or it is sexual spores, but they reproduce by spores. And what is the significance of reproduction by spores? When the spores can easily and very rapidly gets distributed to a larger area, so by spores it can get distributed very fast to a larger area, clear. And since they are very thick walled, so they can tight over the unfavorable condition, and so only favorable germinates in favorable condition only, and so it is more obvious. So it is more obvious that they will successfully germinate to form new hyphae and then mycelium. And fungi has that very resistant wall of chitin, so they successfully grows there. So spores are one of the important reason for this extensive distribution of fungi throughout the world. Now, so today till this, next we will do the sexual reproduction and classification of fungi.